all have our favourite combos. Ingredients that just work perfectly together. They're always on our shopping list. The danger is that these favourites can become a bit predictable, which is why I like to bring something new to these existing relationships.
Some of our favourite culinary marriages are with the most basic of ingredients. Potatoes and leeks is one that works very well.
So I want to bring them together as the base of a sumptuous chowder. Start by placing the chopped leeks into a warm pan of butter and adding some thyme.
I want the leeks to cook very gently in the butter. I don't want them to brown. And the best way to do that is put a little bit of paper on top so that they actually steam as much as they fry. And I put the lid on as well so that no one's keen to escape.
To give a little body, add some potatoes.
Potatoes in. Into this soup, or stew, whatever you want to call it, I'm going to put some smoked haddock. And I want the haddock to go quite a long way, because it's not the cheapest of fish. I'm going to use sweetcorn. And the reason for that is because the liquid in this soup is actually going to be milk. And sweetcorn loves dairy produce. I always cook my smoked haddock in milk. I'm sure there's some very technical reasons for it, but I do it because my mum did it. Milk softens the smokiness of the haddock. It's also wonderful with the sweet corn.
Drop in a few bay leaves and a sprinkling of peppercorns. Your fish should be ready in under 10 minutes.
It is more than a single marriage of ingredients. Actually a marriage of the leeks and potatoes and the milk and the sweet corn all comes together.
Break the haddock into chunks, drain some of the milk, and resettle to the chowder.
Dishes like this, which are really calming, they've got a quality to them that brings a sense of peace into your supper. Very gentle and old-fashioned about these flavours and these smells, and especially these ingredients.
Everything in this dish has a classic connection. Leeks to potatoes, milk to sweet corn, and fish to some freshly chopped parsley.
There are some recipes I like to put on a plate, pop them in front of everybody. And there's other recipes that I like to put in the middle of the table with a big ladle and get people to help themselves. And this is one of those. It's bowl food, sort of soul food.
Has to be the bond between so many of the ingredients in this supper that makes it absolutely mouthwatering.